Alrighty, hey there guys, how are we all doing? Are we ready for to go back to doing some more decks? Cause I did get back to cause I did fix my not yet, Edgy. We're not doing that yet. We're doing Gex. But I did get the file back to where we were at the last stream. Cause why the fuck would you have a oh, do you want to save when you in the second game but not in the third one? That is stupid. Gonna let kill comps earlier good. Yeah, hoping that we should be able to get through the set through Lake Flash and Flaccid and start a little bit in Slappy Valley today, depending on where we're going. No problem, Edgy. Yeah, so we do have at least two moves. We did leave off with halfway through the Dharma Channel. We didn't go halfway through Lake Placid, because we still have two and a half stages left, but that's fine. Like I said, I'm hoping we're going to be able to get through wrap up the second world and start up the third group. Boy, I'm not looking forward to the third group. I really am not, because I do not like Slappy Valley. Worlds of Slappy Valley are some of my least favorites. Anyway, jump back in, and let's return to War's Heck. Oh, something I do actually want to point out, I'm really disappointed that we didn't get one of my favorite lines in Clueless in Seattle. Basically, Gex just goes, "The Playboy Mansion, yes!" Like, he actually refers to it as the Playboy Mansion, which, that's just funny. Alright.
Ryan, I don't know Ryan, but if it gets me a tongue full of bugs, that's my mission.
Saving Private Ryan joke. Because that's the current timeline. Anyway, since we are going to be going a bit further in this one, we are going to be grabbing everything.
This helmet is going to move.
Alright. Alright, yeah, cool. Then we got five of the paw coins. Alright. Remaining five should be in the I did. We are going to go back in the box trench because I honestly didn't go in there while catching up, so that's one thing that I did miss. But since there are fly points in there, so that's kind of why I chose not to. But overall, basically, the state of the game is the same. We still have 7 hits. We have basically the first world 100% and the in the Egyptian level 172. So all we're missing is just this stuff.
Don't get killed in big loud roar.
Yeah, some of these don't have hitboxes. That's the one thing I find really dumb. That basically, not every wall has a hitbox.
Thank you.
Seven Nation Army. I've never heard that song, so I have no idea what the hell you're talking about, Edgy. I really don't. Alright. That is everything here, so let's get back to the main portion of the map so we can go through and grab everything. Gotcha, I don't really play those games. That explains why I don't understand it. Anyway, enter the bunk so we can grab some more flight points. I have no idea what the point of that New Jersey map is for. So you got me why that's there.
The Pentagon spent $25 million on this one temple.
I love that.
Hey, no kid, did I miss the make love, not war level?
I love that. I think that's one of my more favorite lines of the stage. The Pentagon spent $1 million on this one level? Like, I just love that joke. What about the jokes? Because they're good. They're always good and timeable.
Surprise, surprise, surprise.
Alright, there's you. Alright, so now we have everything in here. Let's get the hell out. And we can go on resuming the level.
Oh God, 40 days in the cooler.
Good
morning, Mental Talk.
Because we have to have a Hogan's Heroes joke. There's also Hogan was a hero. There's another one. I think my favorite Hogan's Hero joke is the one that is the fact that the show Recess did an entire episode based off it. Like they did one single cartoon in which basically the kids did spend time with the old person, and basically the leader kid spends his time with what was essentially the main character from Hogan's Heroes. I think it was even voiced by the same actor. I would not be surprised with that. Anyway, now we enter the combat maze.
This is the 60s had run and hide. Of course, I have sideburns and helmet.
Here we have freaking grenades. So they're the most annoying enemies in here. Basically, a lot of the stuff are down here. Thank you. But we are going to be taking out the searchlights. Like I said, there are. That was me. That was due to me. There we go. Alright. Let's get moving. There we go. I think the mines only go off if you land on it. Though, if you just do jumps over them, you're good. But still, just be careful. Let's get some health back, because we really do need some of it. Did I not take damage? No, I did not take damage. Why? I'm living with that, but it's like, holy crap, why did I not take damage? Because I forgot about that grenade. I don't know. Who cares?
Where are you from, son? Texas? Holy!
What shot me? What hit me then? That fucking grenade. That the grenades suck. Okay, the grenades suck. They have the worst hitboxes in the game. Like, those are shitty hitboxes. It's not really Gex, because, like... There. No Pepper games. I don't get that joke. And if anyone understands that joke, please tell me. Because I really do not get that. Like, my dad was in the army, and I don't get that joke. Well, they're all Paul's tokens, so that's good. I think all we need left are just remaining. Yeah! All we need left are missing 13 flight points. Hoping aren't all in. Four left.
Time to go postal.
Oh. That was actually missed. Oh. Okay, so we are now missing only one coin.
Hey, no kidding, did I miss to make love not more love?
There we go. I do admit the guns and this kind of stuff.
Where are you from, son?
Tail up on and mission complete. But we are missing one fly coin, so we do need to scour the level to go and find that. So basically, let's go scour the level for the last flight coin.
I'd be sobbing by now.
Didn't check out where even dead end. So.
Hi, is this the Gex fan club?
Yeah, there it is. How are you doing?
Yeah, doing alright.
Well, we just finished the level, so at least we don't have to go to war anymore.
Let's get it on!
So now we are halfway through Lake Placid. We have two of the four levels done. And I believe we do have the ability to go fight the boss. I'm actually gonna check. Yeah, we do. We do have the access to the next boss. But we're not gonna fight him. First off, time to go take care of bonus level here.
It's tail time.
Now let's see if this is a repeat. No, it's not. It's actually one related to the level we just did. Actually.
Right. Oh, by the way, Seven Nation Army, that's a song that goes like da 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 da.
Oh, okay, I think I might have heard that, I don't remember.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty popular along both, you know, war games, war movies, and meme culture because of it.
Well, if it comes out of memes, everything.
Yeah. I mean, the problem is, memes aren't really what they used to be anymore. Memes used to be funny, now memes are just laugh at this because I tell you to.
Yeah.
Like, that's pretty much the only explanation I can find for why some memes are actually, you know, popular. Like, you know, it's kind of like rap. It used to be good. But nowadays it's so saturated with nothing but fucking trash that you just cannot take it serious anymore.
Oh, definitely. Like, honestly, in terms of memes, I like Simpsons memes. Simpsons and SpongeBob are good for memes.
Oh, yeah. They totally are.
I mean, hell, I love the crap out of the Bart smashing Homer with a chair. I love the fact that so many people do that type of stuff.
Yeah, and as someone who watched a lot of Simpsons back in the day, I do appreciate it when, you know, people do remember that a show was at one point indeed good.
Yeah.
And SpongeBob, well, need I say anymore? Like, that's pretty much gold. You can take, you know, it's basically like the prequel movies. You can take any point, any scene from it, and turn it into a meme.
Mm. Interesting note, by the way. Do you know that Michael Jackson wanted to be in episode 1?
From SpongeBob?
No. Star Wars.
Oh.
He wanted to be Jar Jar.
I mean, that's pretty much the only time I recall someone wanting to be Jar Jar, but...
I think Michael Jackson as Jar Jar Binks would have made him, his character a lot better.
Yeah, I mean, it really depends, because, you know, there's only so much you can... I don't know. Like, Jar Jar was one of those characters that...
Fuck him.
Yeah, so it's been a while since I actually went ahead and watched the Star Wars movies, and the last time is probably like maybe even 10 years ago.
I've never seen a Star Wars movie.
Really?
Nope.
Hmm.
I played Star Wars games. The Lego Star Wars games.
And oh yeah, but come on, that's cheating because Lego Star Wars is fucking dope.
Alright, I do want to return to the secret level real quick, because there is actually something that I noticed in this while doing the replaying that I want to show off. I never actually didn't notice this until the many times I was doing the redoing this, because I died and lost time, got timeout. Yes, I actually did drown because I didn't pay attention to my air. Oh, god damn it. Press X, game. And also, by the way, I still have no idea what the power-up in this stage is doing is for. Like, at least in Tut TV, it's used for basically burning the scarab. Anyway.
Right.
Yes. There is a gold statue of Gex in the stage that I completely missed. It's actually kind of cool.
What the fuck?
Richard Fuller's.
Wait, okay. Oh, God damn it. What year did this game turn out? Came out.
And I figured. Alright, hold on. There.
Aw, you beat me to it.
God damn it, I hate that. There.
Alright, in that case, I should probably,
Probably what?
Yeah, I probably didn't tell you this before. But one thing I do for every channel I mod is whenever I find one of those, you know, one of those bots, I just instantly go like to every channel I mod for and ban the bot. So, yeah.
Alright.
So that's gonna keep me busy.
And now it's time to go western. Stern with the Oregon Trail.
Wait, really?
Yeah, that's literally what it's called. And the play.
Wow.
And for the missions for this, we have visit the world's largest mound of poop, collect five of a kind, and climb the mountain. Yes, we're climbing a mound of poop.
Yeehaw, little doggy. Right.
When we climb the mountain, that's when we're going to be going for everything. By the way, fuck these chickens. There's so many of them, and they all give you fly points. You're gonna spend at least maybe 5-10 minutes chasing all of them. Goddamn, you need to have another stage which does. Oh, here's chasing thing. Also, we don't have to ride the donkey the entire way, but it helps. Anyway. Anyway. Now the poop time. Yeah, this is literally basically the shortest of the missions. Other missions we have are these ghostly gunslingers because we need to have ghosts, Wild West ghosts, and they take more than one hit. Because, sure, why not? Also, this is the level that made me realize I hate when games do the swinging platform bit. Just because it's really stupid. And there's the first mission done. Unfortunately, you cannot finish the stage on your ass.
Lock and load, little lizard.
And yes, I will be referring to donkey as an ass because that's what they're called.
Hey there, you're looking mighty tired after a long day on the prairie. Are you one of those urban cowboys?
Alright. That's my... Why do I keep forgetting about her?
I have another idea.
Because, basically, she's only seeable when you finish the first mission of each level.
My god.
And they do have to have section when you windows. Time to talk.
Hail time. Why do you say that?
Well, they do.
How do you fuck a gecko?
I don't know. Honestly, and it's not the first time they end the game with Gex implying he had sex with the girl, with the human.
How do you fucking gecko?
I don't know, but at least the first time they do it, it's not as creepy as this. Because the first time they do it, they actually use the girl from Pandemonium. They actually go, oh hey, here's the video game girl. So honestly, while it's still weird, it's better than the first game. It's better than what they do here.
How do you fucking gecko?
I don't know, but at least with the video game girl, they can easily better imply it. I have a woman that looks like freaking Pamela Anderson. You feel lucky, punk? Well, Pamela Anderson slash... Yeah, and Misaki does have a point. Furries.
Yes, but that doesn't hide the fact that Gex is also the size of a gecko. So, the most sexual interactivity he can have is... Okay, now that I see him next to... Wait, is that a human?
No. No, that was a grave digger. An undead grave digger.
Is it the same size as a human?
It's the same size as the gun ghost, as the gunner ghost, so yeah.
Okay, in that case, I guess it's slightly possible for Gex to... Why am I thinking about this? Then again, there's also people going like, it's hip to fuck bees, so... Eh.
The only people who are saying that are the fucking writers of B-movie, okay?
Yes, but it's hip to fuck bees, so... You know.
Okay. Yeah, Edgy, am I gonna have to start thinking... I'm not gonna make joke time, actually, away from this game. Oh, crap. Shoots at you. Good. Anyway, Edgy, are we gonna have to start seeing you as the woman from the B movie?
No.
Good.
But all I'm saying is that I would love for Barry B. Benson to sting me.
Swinging for the fences, baby! Why do I have messed up people for friends?
Hey, look, sometimes I'm asking myself the same thing. I mean, you like Gex.
Hey, it's not a bad game series.
Then where is the Gex Ultimate Trilogy?
I don't fucking know. Sony, okay, why don't you get off your asses and actually do some stuff like this?
If Gex is so good, then why... Isn't there the Gex Triple Extreme or Triple?
Again, look at Sony.
Is Sony the one who has hands on the license, though?
I actually don't know.
I mean, did Gex game ever come out outside of PlayStation?
This game and Enter the Gecko are also on the N64. Where the fuck did the donkey go? Where the fuck did you go, you little ass?
Well, actually, it's a donkey.
It's the same thing. Oh, I'm sorry. Is this one of your relatives?
No.
Boxcar Willie is my favorite hobo.
Don't be talking shit about my relatives. At least I have important people in my family.
Yeah. I also love the fact that he does a howdy doody joke.
Wait, really?
Yeah. Howdy, there's some duty.
Oh.
Well, it's the humor.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, I don't know what to think of the humor of this game because on one hand, it's mostly pop culture, right?
Yeah, which is why, honestly, I would not mind if this series is brought back and they do a lot more meme-y. They do, and they make it meme-y, because it already was doing it in the original games.
Yeah. I mean, if they're going to do a modern take on it, or, you know, a reboot of the series, I wouldn't mind it. But at the same time, you do gotta wonder if they would do the actual proper memes, the good memes.
Yeah.
Because the last thing I want to see is a fucking Gex Pog.
Unless I hit Pog, they probably would do it.
Yeah.
I mean, at least those idiots doing Bubsy didn't.
I mean, hey, maybe that's the next one Gex is going to fuck. Fucking Bubsy.
Fuck no. Gex is at least good.
But Bubsy also had good games, right?
Fuck no.
You sure?
Edgy, the first game has fall damage in a 2D platformer.
Yeah? I mean, Donkey Kong has fall damage in 2D platform. People love that game.
Those screens are also fucking small. Anyway, let's read the gravestones. Cactus Carl, he was scum. Jesse Jimmy, he had it coming. Dingus McCurdy, nobody liked him. Bill Angies, piano player. And that's all of them. Wyatt L. Upchuck. Which is a good to get going for a card. Oh, and Paul. Thank you, camera. Like, goddamn. Okay, we can't do the same thing. Alright. This one, yep, there's the last card. And that appears basically in the and that one little cave with this stage is kind of one of my least favorites for doing the getting everything, because you have to go almost everywhere for this one. I mean, granted, yeah, we've been doing that a lot, but this one's kind of the first one at it, because it's a tall level. This is essentially the tall, tall mountain of Gex.
Right.
Okay, no. We're dying. We are not going to die. We're exiting the fucking level. This does have some of my least favorite enemies because, oh hey, let's have some freaking ranged enemies. Granted, it's the Western, so it works, but still. Let's get it on. And now it's time to get everything in this last mission. Yeah, that is right, Gex. Because we're gonna be spending the first few minutes fucking chasing chickens, because goddamn, we have to have a crap ton of chickens. Luckily, they only give out one.
This is joke, right?
Yes. I mean, no, it's not. We have to chase down these chickens for fly coins, because sure, why not? You be a lucky punk?
At least not these other chickens.
I think there's... Oh, and by the way, this is another stage that the draw distance really makes a lot... is really bad for. Mostly because of the fact that there's no real, skybox. It's just a night sky. It's like,
Yeah, you mentioned before how this game also came out on the N64.
Yeah.
Does that version have more draw distance?
I have no idea. I've never played the N64 version of either of the Gex games.
Right. Yeah, because from what I understand, the N64 does have a lot more power than the PS1, so it shouldn't have any problem, rendering it. But at the same time, I mean, it's still a lot of compromises considering how N64 cartridges could only hold 64 megabytes rather than the awfully generous 700 megabytes. Like, the N64 could have been so amazing, but they fucked it up.
Well, Nintendo still wanted to use cartridges, so it's like, it's not really their fault. Like, the only thing I'll fault them for is using no end labels.
No what labels?
No end labels. Just because NES and Super NES games had end labels. With the N64, you just have to go, okay, what am I holding up?
Go ahead.
Yeah.
So actually look at it. Gecko's got a no end
limitation. I mean, I wouldn't see that as a problem if you have like 3 or 4 games, but if you're like an avid collector of games, well, because wasn't there like a really big market for stickers or labels?
Yeah. Back to the mound of poop to collect the fly coins.
Because why the fuck not?
Yeah, this is honestly one of my least favorite stages for doing the for the 100 fly coins. Because just like I said, it's the tall mountain of this game. Like,
yeah.
And there's so many drops. They do a decent amount of checkpointing, but honestly, the fact that they don't put one near the mound of poop, which, yeah, I understand. Oh, you're near a goal, but it's like, still, if you're doing the 100 fly coin mission, it's kind of really shitty.
You did not just make a crap joke there, right?
No. I don't, toilet humor only gets me if it's not used in a gross way.
Yeah, I mean, it's a kind of humor I've always hated. It's like, I don't know.
Like, you have to make it unexpected in order to get a laugh at, in order for me to laugh at out of poop joke.
Yeah.
Like when Catechurus did the Lego episode a few weeks ago. Like, basically, Baddie's head flying off the fart sound. That got a chuckle out of me. Because that was just, okay, is he going to use a silly voice clip? Oh, okay, he's using a fart. That's funny. You'd be a lucky punk. You know, it's like, but it's like certain times, like if it's way too easy, I don't like it.
Yeah, I mean, look, I know all about it because when I went to I guess a Dutch equivalent to high school, a lot of my classmates were really immature, and unfortunately, they all knew each other already because they went to school previously with each other. So pretty much the entirety of the humor was forced toilet humor, and I fucking hated it.
Gotcha. All right, well, at least we got through the mountain. At least we did it without dying. Thank God for that. Hope we can make good checkpoint. Good. Hit the checkpoint with 54 out of 100 fly coins. That's very good. So let's also see if we can check ourselves without pausing. Alright, so we're missing only 6 paw coins and 1 bonus, which we do know where the last bonus coin and 1 paw coins are. Also, hey there, winning catch. How are you doing, dude?
Yeah.
And yes, Gex is a classic. Not as much of a classic as like Mario and some other platformers, but it's still a decent game. I'm doing good. Yeah, so, yeah. There we go. Fortunately for you, the only way to get rid of the the skeleton, the more guys. I can't remember what the old western version of those, what the old west of those things of those guys were called. You need to tail up their head back to them. Unfortunately, you do have to use your tail. Huh, cool. There's one, so I'm using four. No. That was actually really lucky. Jump off and then immediate. That was Ultra Instinct. That was Ultra Instinct. Okay, that was Ultra Instinct.
Yeah, you can have that one. Okay, so let me ask you something. What would you rather have? For the Gex trilogy to be remade from scratch, like
from
with
scratch.
The...
From scratch.
No, I wasn't done talking. Would you rather have a remade trilogy from scratch or a reboot, just like with Crash Bandicoot 4?
Okay, that's actually, okay, now I see why you stopped me. Honestly, I would like them to do what they did with Crash. Start with the ground up reboot.
No, you can only have one.
The ground up reboot, then. Especially if it will end up like Crash and turn into basically a franchise revival.
Yeah. Hopefully without the crappy card racing game with micropayments in it.
Well, Gex only had 3 games.
So yeah.
Also, Nitro Fuel, despite the lie, is not a bad game. It's still damn good. In fact, it's honestly better than what it was originally.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Yes, I'm just not gonna forgive them for.
Oh no! I totally understand doing that. That is totally understandable. That is totally understandable. But it's like I'm not letting that hurt my enjoyment of the game. I'm not letting that hurt my enjoyment of the game. Also, yeah. Oh, hey, what's in here? A hidden area. I do not remember how you get to here. So I need to actually look at. Guide I have. So I'm still gonna be here. I'm just gonna pause in. Oh, okay. Honestly, not really, because I actually completely there it is. I totally forgot about the about the fact that the camera is not under your control. Also, get it? It's a watering hole. There's a mini pool under it.
You have no camera control whatsoever?
No. The only way to get the camera to move is basically you have to stand still.
You have 2 really capable side buttons, and you don't use them.
Yep. Well, you can.
You have a perfectly capable right stick.
It's basically the spiral one system, though. But still, if you wanted to actually lock behind you well, you just need to be standing still.
Go ahead, make my lunch.
But yeah, it's like, and yeah, I'm with you. Ever since Spyro 2, I really feel that games should have started using the second stick for camera control.
Yeah, I mean, it's for that reason we can bless the remakes. Speaking of which, I probably at one point need to start my Spyro
job. Yes, you fucking do.
But I have a backlog.
Boxcar Willie is my favorite Pokemon. I don't care. If
I do.
If you've never played Spyro, play it. Play Crash too, but honestly, I'm not as big of a fan of Crash than I am Spyro, to be honest. Like, I like Crash and Spyro. So, I grew up more with Spyro.
Well, if you like Crash and Spyro, you're going to love Spyro Orange.
Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you.
Crash Purple, then?
Fuck you.
Come on, they can't be that bad.
All they are fucking minigame collections.
And why is that a bad thing?
Not in the fun way.
Wait, okay, if you want the minigame collection, then maybe you'll love Crash Bandicoot Bing Bong.
What? Oh, Crash Bash.
No, Crash... The one on the DS.
Oh, Crash Boom Bang. Oh, fuck no.
Oh, Boom Bang.
I've never played that one, and fuck no. It was fun play. True, but we also have the Spyro Trilogy, well, the Game Boy Advance Spyro Trilogy, and we also have the two Crash Game Boy Advance games too. Which those were...
Oh, yeah.
What?
Oh, yeah. The Big Adventure, right?
Big Adventure and M-Trains for Crash and Season of Ice, Season of Flame, and Attack of the Rhinox for Spyro, which all those are damn good. Even if the art style for Attack of the Rhinox is super weird. Oh no, I enjoyed the crud out of the Game Boy Advance game for both Crash and Spyro.
Except the crossover event.
Yeah. Because whoever thought of that is a fucking dumbass. Come here, chickens. Need to kill a few fucking fight. Goddamn,
I do play that at one point in my life. I did play a Spyro game. I know my uncle and aunt had one on the PS2. I played back in the day.
Do you remember what it was called?
I've got no fucking clue. All I knew is it was Spyro. It was on the PS2.
Okay, were you beating creatures up?
I really don't know. I remember there was a button where you could basically dash. I know there was a button for breathing fire. So,
sorry about that.
I know there was a jump I had difficulties making where I had to run, jump, and glide to something in the early beginning of the game.
Lucky punk? Okay. Do you remember the hub world you were in, if any?
No.
Damn it.
Like, keep in mind, this is something like from
is
12 years ago.
There are a bunch of Spyro games on the PS2. There is Spyro Enter the Dragonfly, which is what Winnie Catch is thinking. He played Enter the Dragonfly. Which I don't know. I'm not 100% sure, to be honest. You never know. That's great. Missing.
Yeah. I mean, again, neither do I. Hell, it might as well have been a PS1 game on PS2 backwards compatibility.
Maybe. I think I remember where missing some are. Back in the graveyard. I forgot that there was some that were in the mausoleums. Hopefully those have the 8 we need. Otherwise, I don't know where else to go.
So, let me ask you something. Because Spyro was pretty popular back in the day, what, quote-unquote, killed the franchise?
Kind of basically the same thing that killed Crash. basically, the games just weren't, didn't sell because they weren't really that good.
Right, and I assume that is because the license got tossed around, like the middle son from divorced parents, right?
Yeah. Okay, so I'm missing... Alright, I'm missing 6 light coins. And 2 paw coins. God damn it. Alright, let's look. Oh, right. That's... I remember where some of these are. Okay. Hopefully this also has the remaining stuff. Also, I really remember that. Alright.
Boxcar really is my favorite hobo.
Go ahead. Make my lunch.
But yeah, it's like... I will admit, though, I like the idea of the, of Crash utilizing, fisticuffs in the CR games a lot more than Spyro does. Mostly because the fact that Spyro is a quadruped.
A what?
Quadruped. Four-legged creature.
Ah.
Yeah. And Crash was bipedal. Which, so he stood on 2 hands, so it actually, 2 feet, so it actually worked for Crash. But, though, I also will admit, the Spyro ones had a lot better story.
Right. Sorry, I have to bail for a moment. I'll be back in hopefully half an hour to 3 quarters.
No problem.
Alright, see you later.
Later. Well, there's all the paw coins, but now we're missing 2 fly coin tokens. Okay, great. Let's check the chickens. Let's check the fucking chickens. Fuck the fact that they put so many fucking tail whipping animals in the stage. Like, God damn it, you guys, don't do the stupid shit like this.
Do you feel lucky, punk?
Crap, don't do that.
Sorry,
I honestly will admit I do find that the stories for Legend of Spyro a lot better. Most of the Crash ones were just mostly, oh, here's Cortex, stop him. Although I will admit I do love the writing for Mind Over Mutant a lot more than Crash of the Titans, because they just decided, oh hey, you know what? We don't take this seriously. Let's just be silly. It was actually the Catechorus review for Minor Mutant that actually made me remember. Oh yeah, I like the writing for it when they the jokes for Minor Mutant.
My tail doesn't like you.
I also did like the fact that that game did do a lot of different audio art styles for the video for each level. Like basically the final one was literally just anime. You know, so it's like that's actually really good. Oh wait, you know what? think I might know where I'm missing some stuff. If I am, I'm gonna be really stupid for forgetting about them. Camera. Thank you. Honestly, I wish that that game developers had realized, having it rushing into the walls is dumb. Let's just have it break it. Like, I mean, she would see into it, but honestly, I'd rather see into a game basically via the camera, then have the camera be stuck on the wall. Not there. All right. All right. Good. I got those. All right. Cool. I got those. Well, it's good, but it's also not good, because I have no idea where I'm missing two. Really hoping they aren't near the dam. Really hoping they're not at the giant poop. Really hoping that. Okay, I'm really hoping that they're not. I'm a little bit worried because if I die, I don't remember I'm a little bit worried because I don't remember if when I get sent back to a checkpoint. Gecko's gotta know his limitations. Anyway, I'm a little bit worried. Now I can get through without something stupid happening. I'm a little bit worried because I don't remember if I die and go to a checkpoint, if my fly coins are saved. I know paw coins and bonus coins are saved. I don't remember if fly coins are saved.
Be a lucky punk.
That's my worry. Like, I'm worried on, I died. Oh, wait, I lost him. You know? So, granted, it does happen with Mario. I'm not. There are some stages I'm not looking forward to doing. I get back to playing that game.
Howdy! There's some duty! Go ahead. Make my lunch. Go ahead. Make my lunch.
I think you can.
Gecko's gotta know his limitations.
Hit me, go on, hit me! You try! Coming through the back.
Chickens. So stupid to hide stuff, the kind of stuff that runs away, which like I hate.
Ugh.
keep our ancestors.
I feel like a fucking jackass. You shut up, donkey. Okay, there's one I missed. That's good. But also annoying, because I don't know if the other one I missed was chicken. Fucking chickens. I get it, Western, but still, don't have this many stuff. I think, because there's a stage in Funky Town that's going to do the exact same thing, but with the pigeons. Why couldn't they put them up here? Assholes. Like, this is why you don't put collectibles in the animals you chase. And if you do, you make them die. Okay? You make them die. Dicks. Like, I'm sorry if this is just boring to everyone, but hey, we are 100%ing this game. So we have to live through the boring stuff. That includes chicken chasing for fly coins. Because, duh. I don't think it's an enemy I missed, though, because... It's like, I don't believe that it would be like that. I have no idea how to get to that one up, so we're not gonna get that, because I also believe that down there is death.
Put that in your pipe and smoke it.
Boxcar Willie is my favorite hobo.
I'm a fixin' to kill you.
Gecko Shore, baby, yeah!
Gecko's gotta know his limitations.
Like, I don't really want to know how long we've been doing this level for, by the way. Cause, like, good god. Fuck chickens!
Boxcar Willie is my favorite hobo.
I will laugh if Veggie comes back and we're still doing this shit. Like, it's like, god damn it. Okay, I will say, okay. If Edgy comes back and we're still doing this, we're just gonna go fuck it. We're gonna finish this mission and get out of here. And I'll do this off screen. That's only if he comes back and we're still doing this. That means, like, there's nothing else I can do. I mean, unless there's a bird that I missed that I can kill for a frickin' point. Honestly, I doubt that. Fuck you. Alright, let's go back to check the mountain poop. Maybe it's over near that. Won't be happy if it is. But at least we'll have it. Alright, not here. But on the poop mountain stuff. If it's here, we're going to take that exit. Never mind. It's not going to be that neat. We'll go and finish this stage. Get out of the western town.
Boxcar really is my favorite hobo.
Just need to have the camera pivoting.
Gecko's gonna know his limitations.
Alright, not around the poop mound. Hold on. No, not on the poop. Alright, cool. So we got like once during that jump, like, egg. There are times when I would clench during jumps and platforms because, honestly, I don't like doing certain jump types. Like, jumping to a moving platform, I hate. That is one thing I wish that we would do away with in platformers. You can call me a coward for it, and yeah, I do deserve it, but it's like, it's just something I feel.
There's gold in them there, Chief!
I could use a theater.
By the way, if you want to know more about what type of stuff and platformers I hate, watch my Zelda Twilight Princess Let's Play. Because the most recent episode was just basically me complaining about how annoying the sky dungeon is. It's that. Because it does a lot of it because duh. And I know it's absolutely terrible for me to go because duh. It's like, that's just my thoughts. Like, a lot of gaming stuff I just like to go is just duh because this game developer seems stupid. I mean, in that episode, I do praise the fact that Breath of the Wild has a jump button. That's kind of one of my favorite things in Breath of the Wild, even though I'm not a fan of the game. And people can go, it's a stupid reason for not liking it. Basically, it's because of the weapon durability system. If you're doing, like, Fire Emblem, totally fine with weapon durability. Zelda should not honestly have it. Okay, Zelda really should not have had that. Okay. It really does not add anything, and it makes it annoying as shit. So I'm hoping for 2 they'll go, okay, yeah, people didn't like this. Let's actually make the, let's make some improvements to this and add a,
go ahead, make my lunch.
Seriously, where the fuck is this? I'm gonna look this up, so give me a quick minute. I am very sorry. About finding that, so we're on our own here, guys.
Gecko's gotta know his limitations.
Like, that's the one point. It's like, I don't know where the hell, where I'm missing if, like, and I'm sorry, like, I'm talking to people, it's like, I'm pretty sure that chat's already been bored because I'm doing the same, been here for almost, what, half an hour? More than that? It's like, crap. Don't do that type of shit. Like, this is one of the worst levels in this game when you're going for all the fly coins because of all the chickens. Like, honestly, it's like they, I feel like basically they should have added another scorpion here. Okay, it's like, or have these things drop fly coins. I'm actually pissed off, it turns out there's a fucking, the fly coin in that spot. Gecko's gotta know his limitations. That's gonna be really shitty. I have no idea how the hell to get to that. Good. Okay, good. It was a fucking chicken. Fuck you, game. Fuck you, game. I narrowed it down to it was one of those chickens in either the beginning or the end, but it's like, goddamn. Don't fucking do that. Don't hide that type of shit in so many fucking fodder. Just make more enemies or make more smashables to basically do that, okay? Don't be fucking idiots. Fucking hate that shit, okay? Nope. You stage. Well, it's not really a stage fall, that was more control. But still, it's like, god damn it. It's like, god fucking damn it. I would love to know how long that fucking took me to finish this part of this mission. I want to, if anyone has been paying attention to the time, please tell me. I would love to see how long that took me. I would actually be pissed if that took me a little. We're finally getting out of here. We have no more stages to do in the Western stage. We are all fucking done. And to make sure I don't, I'm A, going to double check. Oh wow, we actually have enough to go to Spunky Town too. Wow. Alright, yeah. 100% done with that stage. Save! Good. Now we only have one last stage. Oh, wait. Bonus here. We have the bonus stage. We have to re-hit that thing, which I think would have reset if we, I think that the bombs would have reset if we entered the stage, so. Yeah, so just do this. Now let's do the bonus for Western stage, and we are good to go to the final stage here. Fuck you! Let's tell you where you were, asshole. Enter the bonus stage.
Lock and load, little lizard.
And it's time back for chickens.
It's bonus time.
And we just need to go find chicken crates. Not smacking chickens, we're smacking their crates. Yes, there are fake, there are ones to basically make you confused.
Boxcar really is my favorite hobo. Rolling, 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 rolling.
Boxcar
really is my favorite hobo.
You trap! Coming through the back.
Time is running out!
You feel lucky, punk?
Last one should be down around this area. Doing this time. Western stage causing so much noise because it's poorly designed, especially because, like I said, this is one of the states that suffers from the fucking raw distance. Just like with, like seriously, it's like this is why I want to see a remake of this series, because of the draw distance fucking sucks. Okay, like straight up.
Gecko's gonna know its limitations.
All right, break these.
Rolling, 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 rolling.
Oh, at least it wasn't where the thing was. Cooper, scoop your burrow. That's funny. There. Fuck off. Now let's hope we never have to do the freaking... Never have to do this damn thing again. Because, God, fuck you. Fuck you, Western. Fuck you. And now, we only have one last pirate... one last level to do. Wrong way. Draw this since you betrayed me. We have the pirate level left. Buccaneer program.
It's hail time.
Here we have survive the wall of death, sink 4 pirate ships, and sip on down to the TV.
Thank you.
Luckily, we'll be getting getting Art Priest number 8. You know, you have to do this every time you enter the stage. But you do the stage, by the way.
Go first.
Our enemies! Alright, chop them because they're sword. And this makes zero sense. You can block their tail whips. You can tail whip them, but it's honestly way better to do and just go and do that. And this is another thing that we have to do every time you do the stage. Like, honestly, this is the most tedious beginning of a stage in this game. Mostly because fuck you, game. Because every time you do the stage, you have to go through this long-ass segment. In all three missions, you have to do this. It's just like taking out that one, opening the first. God damn it! It's just like opening the first arc in Tut TV. It's super fucking annoying. And it's like, why did you decide to put that in the game? Okay, why did you decide to put this type of shit in the game? There we go. I have no idea why they put a checkpoint in here. That's also really dumb, to be straight honest. This for cannon to appear over a little bit later. Oh wait, no, not a little bit later. We actually need that now. Yes, the cannon is only for getting rid of the pirate, the two pirate. Because honestly, I would rather do that than fucking kick them on all platforms. Yeah. Luckily for the last bit, you don't do this, but you do have to barrel. Good.
Rank up with Gilbert with Sullivan, dude.
And there we go. We have made it to 2. The Wall of Death.
Go.
Welcome back.
Hey.
The fly plane was in a fucking. We're sending a fucking chicken in the beginning of the level.
That sounds amazing.
Yeah, that's why you don't fucking do that type of shit.
Oh hey, cool.
We now have 7 hits. Not noticed that I've gotten those extra ones, but hey, now we have 8 hits.
Nice work, Peckling.
Hard me, wench. When this is over, we can play pirate, and Blackbeard the Gecko will be.
So. Oh, wait, sorry. Important stuff happening.
Hard me, no, alright. Well, if you need me, I'll be out there somewhere trying to save you.
Like, she has such amazing hair.
I honestly always confuse her with Carmen Electra, but it's not her.
Yeah.
Well, it worked for Douglas Fairbanks.
Now it's time to redo the climbing and jumping segments again. God damn it, we have to do this all for every, for all three runs. Fuck you, Brad.
Go, sir. Captain Stubby needs a back rub.
Anyway, welcome to the pirate level. Oh, right. I took the damage from the guy. So we have that Paul coin.
I deck it. Nido deck is stupid.
Next, we just probably jump over to the platform that holds the checkpoint.
Yeah.
Because we don't need to go that way until we're actually working on 100% again, which will be in the next mission.
Oh, by the way, totally random segue, but speaking of pirates, is One Piece any good?
Yes.
Well, the
yes,
I mean the games. The games. I mean, I'm not going to watch the entirety of One Piece.
Oh hell yeah! Oh hell no! Honestly, if you want to get into it, either join us for movie nights, which if you don't want to, that's fine. By the way, for those watching that aren't part of Discord, we have movie nights every Friday.
Shit, you
immediately have the same idea. We have movie nights every Friday. We have just finished the Drum Island arc, and we are going on to the final story of the Alabasta Saga, Alabasta itself. Reminder, those are every Friday. Day, if you want to join up, just then drop me a message onto Discord. Yes, for One Piece games, I recommend grabbing Pirate Warriors 3 and 4.
Yeah, because they were recommended to me on Steam because they have some sort of weird-ass pirate show going on right now.
Oh, what? Oh, because of Talk Like Pirate Day, okay.
Wait, so One Piece... Yeah, I'm seeing right here, One Piece Pirate Warriors 4, it's like $30.
Yeah, that's a damn good price for it.
What are the games about?
Basically, have you ever played a Warriors game?
Like Dynasty Warriors?
Yes, Dynasty Warriors.
I played the demo for Hyrule Warriors on my Wii U and
okay,
CDS.
You played Hyrule Warriors. Okay, basically...
No, I played the demo.
It's basically that, but with a One Piece skin. But it basically takes... stuff, but it's basically a damn good retelling of the anime.
Wait, hold up.
My only gripe with 4 is that it doesn't do a whole lot of retelling. But
Koei Tecmo, isn't that the same developer of like
Yes.
Right. I mean, in that case, maybe, but at the same time, I feel like if I'm going to begin with a, you know, warrior game, I'm probably going to begin with Hyrule Warriors, because one of the people I follow...
One Piece is a bit more
really
streamlined than... the Pirate Warriors games are a bit more streamlined than Hyrule Warriors, because you don't have to... because basically, you don't have to get kills and hope, oh, I hope I got a material drop.
Well, yeah, but Hyrule Warriors is getting a tie-in game to Breath of the Wild, and I absolutely fucking love Breath of the Wild.
I still also recommend Pirate Warriors, though. It's like, it's damn good.
Yeah, I mean... I guess I'll see. Like, I'm probably going to pick it up on sale. But the problem is, well, the sale is currently ongoing, and... it's on for 17 and a half more hours. However, I'm out of money. So.
Well, I'm between jobs, so don't look at me. I'm not gonna gift you Pirate Warriors 4.
Look, I never.
Because I'm just okay, a job. So if I had a job, I honestly would do it.
Look, I'm gonna be perfectly blunt. I don't like being gifted stuff.
Okay.
So I wouldn't ask it from you anyway.
Okay.
I just feel like if someone gives me something, I have
you
to play.
You feel obligated
and
to get something back.
Yeah, and well, that as well. But it's like my cousin, for example. He gifted me Helldivers on Steam a couple of years ago. It's basically. Have you ever heard of it?
No.
Well, it's a Sony IP. It's one of the rare examples of Sony actually putting their games on Steam. But it's like,
also just
imagine it's a kind of top-down perspective where you have to shoot stuff and work together. But I barely played it. As a matter of fact, I don't think I even ever played it without him. Because he gifted it to me, I feel bad because, well, I never even touched it. And it's a general thing. I feel like if someone is going to buy me stuff, it has to be me. Or it has to be on birthdays or something, but that's a totally different story.
Gotcha. Also, I just realized I don't remember if that platform has a way to come back to the main part of the ship. And there's a fly coin there. So we're gonna go and collect all the stuff right now. I'm an idiot and completely totally forgot about that.
Yeah. But it's also the main reason why I don't like being gifted subs as well on Twitch.
Yeah, gotcha. That's understandable.
Yeah, but like recently I've had a couple of times where someone gifted me a sub to someone I don't even know about. And to be clear, both parties, both the person I got sub to and the person gifted me the sub, I never knew them. And I'm just like, who the fuck is this? Is this like some sort of cheap tactic for someone to get more followers? Because if you're trying to get more followers, oh, I know a site where you can get more followers. We just banned someone because of it.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know, I just feel like whenever I get gifted a sub, I need to, you know, make the sub worthy of its money. But like, I don't want to be forced to, and I know that I'm not being forced, but it's just like, I feel like I have to go there from that point. And that's why I just buy my own subs, because, well, I know who I respect, I know who I idolize, and I know who I'm going to watch. Like, you know what I mean, right?
Yeah. There. And no, I don't believe that the wall of death basically goes, oh, I hit you, you're dead. It just deals damage.
Yeah.
At least we're doing this almost early. I mean, it's just been one mission, but it's like, honestly, at least it's not as bad as the fucking Western. I really want to know how long that actually took. Like, fucking A, game. Why you don't do fodder enemies that give off rewards? They just make them small little useless things. Oh, nice, Misaki.
Is Mega Man any good?
Yes.
I mean,
I prefer X over the classic series, though, mostly because the classic series can get really obnoxiously bullcrap at times.
Yeah, I would personally also prefer the X series because of the, how can I say this the best way to put it? Because they have a little bit of a darker tone, and it may sound cliche, but like, I like a darker tone in video games, if you guys didn't know that already. Like, did I ever say that? That I like my games to be darker?
Yes, Ezio, we know. You're a brooding edgelord and you want to sit in your room listening to metal music.
Well, you're kind of right, except for the metal. I don't know why, but I don't really like metal that much. I've listened to Judas Priest a couple of times, but that's pretty much the only thing. But no, I feel like X is also one of those series which takes a lot of things from the original series that worked and scrapped a lot of stuff that didn't work. And also, it started on the SNES, so more graphical fidelity.
Mega Man X1 is a much better game than Mega Man 7. Is also on this Super Nintendo.
What about Mega Man X7?
We don't talk about X7.
What, you think that game should burn to the ground?
Yes.
Burn!
And honestly, and yes, Saka does have a point. I'm not a big Star Force person, to be honest. I think that tried way too hard to be a successor to Battle Network. And so it kind of lost its identity a lot. But it's not that bad. Like, this honestly, the spin-off series that they do for certain series, like, they haven't done a spin-off series for Classic, which that kind of sucks. The Mega Man Zero series for X, I don't like the Zero series because, honestly, they do a lot of stupid shit for that.
What about Mega Man and Knuckles? I mean, and Bass.
Motherfucker, if you want to play Mega Man and Bass, then I'm not fucking gonna listen if you play about it.
Yeah.
It's fuck Mega Man and Bass. That is fucking that is honestly one of the worst Mega Man games ever.
Yeah, I was quite interested in the Mega Man X series before this. So, I should probably ask, when it comes to graphical fidelity, is there a difference between the X collection on, PS4 or Switch?
No, it's Capcom. They don't fuck, they just, I would say this, they're not Square lazy, and they actually could know, oh hey, let's actually do versions of that people want to play.
What do you mean Square is lazy? Don't you know that Final Fantasy 15 Pocket Edition is the best way to experience
No, I don't mean
with,
I don't mean
with
that.
Even more holes in it.
I don't mean that. I more mean basically about the fact that they did that for Dragon Quest XI, the expert, the special edition for that. Oh gee, we have a Switch version. Let's port that to everything. Oh wait, it's not gonna be. He is optimized for everything but the Switch. Meh.
Yeah, that's right. Didn't they make the Switch version of Dragon Quest XI, which is apparently the best version? Didn't they hold up?
They made it for everything and they did not optimize it for everything.
Oh yeah, Dragon Quest XIS. I mean, it is only $40, but it... Wait. 2 months?
If you're getting Dragon Quest 11, you get it on the Switch.
I mean, on PC it has better graphics.
No fuck does it.
Yes it does, because it's on PC. That's a general rule. If it's on PC,
every version of Dragon Quest 11 S, even the PS4 version, they're all optimized for the Switch.
Well, then I get more frame rate.
No.
You sure?
Yes.
It's locked at 60.
It's hard to it. Like I said, the optimal way to play Dragon Quest 11 is playing the Switch version.
Wait. Okay, so I'm looking at a community forum right now on Steam. Boycott this piece of trash game.
Mm-hmm.
Square Enix refused to offer a discount/upgrade to owners of the original.
Well, they're also doing that stupid thing.
Don't get me wrong, but I don't quite understand why people feel entitled to get this for free. True Dragon Quest fans will gladly double dip.
Yeah.
So many Japanese versions of the game, do they do this? Public service announcement. This is a port of the Switch game. It won't look as good as the OG version.
Mm-hmm.
There has been an upgrade option for this game. Would have been happier with Dragon Quest 8, honestly. What's the difference? Should I get Steam or PlayStation version? Still no Japanese text. Tell me if I'm wrong. Square just took a dump on all of us.
Yes, it did.
Anyone figure out what the S stands for?
It's special.
Is it not the Switch game?
It's special.
Is it okay to buy it for those who didn't get the original? We, all caps, deserve Definitive Edition 2. Why the next 4 months are going to suck? Wow, like... $40? Is this a joke? Okay, yeah, people are getting pissed about this.
Which is understandable considering the fact that, oh gee, let's not work on this, let's get it out ASAP. Because again, they're not making any changes, they're just basically putting the Switch version onto the stuff.
If I mention it, Final Fantasy 15 on Switch is really fucking good.
Down on the Switch, it's the mobile crap, okay? Fuck
yes,
off.
but it's still Final Fantasy 15.
No one likes the Pocket Edition.
Well, I mean, to be fair, the Pocket Edition was the first.
15 is still an unfinished game.
Look, the Pocket Edition was my first way of experiencing Final Fantasy 15. And the story was alright.
The story, it's also, like I said, not complete.
Well, yeah, but neither is it in a fucking Royal Edition, so...
What?
Neither is it in a Royal Edition.
Yeah, like I said. Because they had plans for Noctis, Arena, and Lunar Freya DLC. And they're turning the Luna Freya thing into a story. Or it was either Luna or Ariana. I don't remember who getting story for their DLC.
If I wouldn't, knowing Square, it's probably both of them.
True. We'll follow you, creature.
And yeah, I do know there's a lot of, you know, Final Fantasy 15 extended universe, something like movies or stuff. Even with the movies and the novels and all that shit, it's still very incomplete.
Yeah, everyone quit after episode Arden.
Like, why is it that they scrapped it? Was the game received too poorly for it?
No, it's basically because everyone I don't. Everyone quit after episode Arden. I don't know why everyone quit after episode Arden.
Huh.
Where the last pirate stuff.
Yeah. But yeah, I do agree that Final Fantasy XV Pocket Edition has its problems, and it was the main reason why I decided to actually play Final Fantasy XV, because I had a PC version at the time. I just didn't have a PC that could run it. And I still don't have a PC that can run it, because Square Enix doesn't understand how optimization works.
Yep. They really do not.
But hey, at least I'm glad to see how Final Fantasy 16 should perform alright. Because they did show that off with the PlayStation event.
I'm excited for that, especially considering Yoshi-P is in charge, and I love the crap out of Final Fantasy 14.
I mean, I didn't, but I have my own reason for that, which I'm not gonna get into.
Yeah, you don't like subscription-based games. You don't like subscription-based MMOs.
More than that. Like, okay, I'm gonna make the explanation very briefly, but one of my more dearer friends, 4 years ago, he got addicted to it. And he still is. But anyway, I did absolutely love Final Fantasy XV, so even though that was my first entry with the Final Fantasy franchise, I'm very excited
play
to see
10.
What Final Fantasy...
Play 10.
I have 10 on the PlayStation 2.
Get the fucking HD version.
No, because it's $50 on Switch.
Cheaper on PS4. The only thing, though, is you have to deal with an ugly as shit save screen.
Look, I'm not too big in RPGs, alright? I think I mentioned it multiple times. And it's by a complete fucking miracle, by the way, that I platinum Persona 5 Royal. Like, I just really dislike turn-based. I just want to have all the action be in my hands. Like, you understand that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Go for it. Captain Scooby needs a
backup. Where's this last coin?
But then, what's so good about 10?
10 is one of the ones that people love a lot. So when you start going into wanting to get into Final Fantasy, it's mostly 10, 7, 9. Those are the kind of ones that people will try to shove in your throats. Like I just did.
Right, 10. So by that logic, I shouldn't pursue a copy of Final Fantasy 8, Final Fantasy 11. Wait, that was an MMO. Or Final Fantasy 12 or 13, right?
Okay, 8, I don't mind 8, but it's basically you have to do a lot of magic grinding. There's a process system, and people don't like that because they don't like being limited in when it comes to magic, even though, oh hey, magic is, magic's limited by MP.
Yeah.
12, people like 12. You don't see it pushed, though. But people do like 12. I don't mind it. It's not one of my two-go Final Fantasy, but I do have Zodiac Age on both the Switch and PS4. 13, I honestly enjoy 13. I enjoy 13, but it's not one of my all-time favorites.
Well, it's not a common favorite Final Fantasy, though.
Yeah.
Like, people love to give shit to Final Fantasy
13,
right?
Yeah. Which a lot of is honestly unneeded.
Lightning returns Final Fantasy 13 because it's shit.
I've not played 13 or 13.2, so I can't say for those, but I do not mind the first 13.
Maybe that's a good idea for an affiliate incentive. You're playing all the shitty Final Fantasy games.
Motherfucker, I have a crap big backlog.
Oh, now you know how it feels, huh? Besides, you already have your incentive, right? Weren't you gonna do like a 100% run of Donkey Kong 64?
No, that was a follower goal, and I'm giving up on those till the backlog's gone.
Right, then do you know what your affiliate incentive is?
Yes, I do know what I'll be playing for the stream after I get affiliate on.
Are you giving it to yourself, or...?
Do people want to know?
I mean, I want to know.
I know you do. What about you guys in chat? Do you guys want to know, or do you guys want me to leave it a surprise?
Rank up with Gilbert and Sullivan, dude! Isaac, Vito Tech is stupid.
All right. For affiliate stream, that in which I get it, I don't know, because I don't know when I'm gonna get it, because that stream definitely did. The stream from Thursday really did help, especially because of Marta's raid.
Yeah.
But I don't know if this one would hurt that or not. That's something I'm worried on.
Well, as I mentioned it before, because of that stream, your average amount of viewers really gets boosted, and you've already shown it, but as time went on, your Let's Watch streams are disappearing, so in all honesty, you could probably get affiliate by not streaming for a while.
Yeah, but... And... Okay, depends on what my numbers look like after this stream. If I do it, then I might go on a little bit of a break. I don't know.
Yeah, because you've been working on it for a really long while, and when I say a really long while, I mean a really long while.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I remember... Okay, how long do we know one another?
I want to say at least 3 years?
Not 3 years.
You sure? It feels like 3 years.
No, the first time I came here, you were playing Astral Chain.
Oh, right, yeah.
Which was... It might have been...
Yeah, when did Astral Chain come out? That was last year, wasn't it?
I don't know. I know I already knew you before November, because I remember you making an announcement advertising my birthday stream, so... we might as well know each other for a year at this point.
Yeah, last year. So I want to say at least maybe 2 years, just to be on the safe side. 1 to 2 years.
Yeah, but I recall how you were pretty much trying for affiliate ever since then.
Oh, shit.
Like, you need a break. But more importantly, you need to break, knowing that things are going to be alright.
Yeah. Yeah, August 30th, 2019. Yeah, about 1 to 2 years. We've known each other.
Wait, hold up. On my end, it says August 31st, 2019.
Either or, about 1 to 2 years.
Also, I forgot that you can do that. How you can click on someone's name on Twitch in a chat and see how long they've been following.
Huh. There we go. Alright, so we only have just a bonus coin left. Just one bonus coin left. Oh boy.
Yeah, time zones. They're definitely a bitch.
Yeah. Yeah, it's like, yeah, like, anyway, as for the affiliate reward game, I'm going to be hurting my arms and playing Rayman Raving Rabbit's TV Party.
Oh, cool, that's one stream I won't be joining then. I fucking hate Rabbit.
Well, it's like TV Party.
Look, you're just admit you're foreshadowing a Persona 4 Golden playthrough and we'll be on our way.
I actually do want to do a Golden playthrough, but no, I don't have a balance board.
Should I send over mine?
No, you don't have to. Ooh, alright. Okay, yeah, this one's gonna be... Luckily, this is the last remote we have to do for this world.
Sweet.
We just have to do the bonus level in this area, and then we have the boss fight. I do want to do a Persona 4 Golden series.
Yeah.
I also want to do Royal, but it's Royal. People would be upset because I would be basically giving all the cutscenes and for a story arc, because honestly, the Kamoshida story arc is basically shit. It's basically just fucking disturbing shit.
Yeah.
Like, did you
already finish Persona 5 Royal, by the way?
I'm working on finishing Xenoblade Chronicles, and then I'm gonna go to Royal.
Okay, did you already play it a little bit?
I'm still in Kamoshida's palace.
Right. Because I do want to say one thing, and I don't know if it's depending on difficulty, but Persona 5 Royal, it's so laughably easy. You know what level I was when I ended the game?
What?
99. You know what my soldier stats were at my first playthrough?
Maxed out.
All maxed out.
Yeah, you know why?
You know what my confidant
third
were?
Semester. They give you a lot more time to max out your social skills, levels, and all of the confidants.
Because yeah, but you know how my confidants were?
All maxed out.
Also, all maxed out. Normally, I'd be relying on New Game Plus in order to do that, but...
Yeah.
I managed to get everything.
Yeah, they learned a lot for that. So it's like, I'm not surprised at the fact that you maxed out level and basically maxed out everything. Because, again,
keep in mind, I'm not an RPG person. And to me, the game was laughably easy. It gets even better if you realize how much money I have.
Persona 5 is one of the easier games to get a crap ton of money in.
Yeah, but do you know how much money I got at one point?
A billion?
A billion?
Yeah.
No, not exactly that. I got 8 million yen.
I think I passed 8 million game I've done. Persona 35 is going to be on PS5 too, but it's like, it's,
yeah,
I don't know.
Vanilla Persona 5.
Yeah, vanilla.
Which, I don't get why they didn't just do Royal, because...
That also still recently came out too, so that's probably why. Oh, shit.
Well, yeah.
Fuck you, camera!
Wow.
Yep.
We'll follow you, creature.
That's why you don't do that type of platforming. Well, that type of crap in a platformer. Because narrow platforms is fucking garbage.
Oh yeah, I cannot wait to finally be able to actually play Nocturne without being relying on a store that doesn't sell it because of religious constraints.
That's
and
what,
Shin Megami,
if you want to ban one Shin Megami Tensei game because of religious constraints, you have to ban the entire series.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like,
I don't know what's the real reason Shin Megami Tensei Nocturne was redone into Lucifer's Call.
Who knows?
I mean, at one point you'd say that Lucifer's Call is even more offensive because, oh, Lucifer, the son of Satan. Ooh, mommy and daddy aren't going to like this game.
Go for
it. So is Persona 5 Misaki. Like, you can't really go, oh, well, this game had God in front of us. So did Persona 5.
Yeah, okay, but to be completely fair...
I mean, fuck. The final boss is
We have become way more acceptant of certain aspects in video games.
Okay, then. The final boss of one of the versions of 2 is Hitler.
No, it's a leader. It's
literally Hitler.
They don't say Hitler.
Well, okay, yeah, they don't say Hitler, but they mention Third Reich.
Yeah.
It's Hitler.
It's obviously
it's
Hitler.
Well, okay, it's not fully Hitler, I will admit, though.
Exactly,
but
it's not fully Hitler.
It's basically Gnarleotep taking the form of Hitler. And Gnarleotep is basically... Gnarleotep is basically the big bad demon of the series. Because a Persona 5 Royal adds minions that served him.
Yeah, so he's deemed as the Führer, which is his name back in World War II, which is German for leader.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's obvious that it's Hitler. But he's Hitler in anything by name. And normally at that point, it will be all right, but then again, it's like that. They became way less bitchy about it. I mean, hell, fucking Wolfenstein 3D technically had a boss fight against Hitler.
Wolfenstein 3D also is about fighting Nazis, dude.
Yeah,
that's the entire series. Yeah, they tried to censor him with sunglasses. Like, I don't know if you've seen how he looks. Look up the Führer.
Yeah, I looked him up.
Okay. Going to a far corner land on a platform. Bonus coin alcove right next to the platform. Ugh.
But yeah, nowadays we do have games like Sniper Elite 4 where one of the enemies is literally Hitler, and it's a full rendition of Hitler, so... I don't know if I should be glad or disappointed in how acceptant the gaming industry got. Though, to be fair, I'm always gonna say that if you want to censor something, let the audience know if they will or won't get it. Because it's also a main problem I have with the way my country's handling things, because some games are just outright not being sold because they contain micropayments.
And yeah, he was in Fusion Reborn. Because that's just really fucking weird, I'll be straight honest, like, why? And we have now finished the final stage of Lake Placid.
Also, this is probably gonna be a big fat no, but did you ever watch the movie Er ist wieder da?
Please type it on chat, because I have no idea what the... Did you use an accent? I have no idea what the heck you said.
Er ist wieder da. It's German for Guess Who's Back.
No, I never have.
Right, so... little. I don't know if you can actually watch it in America, because it is a German movie and completely voiced in German. But basically, it's a quote-unquote comedic movie in which Hitler returns to the current age and, well, yeah.
I want to look at Jojo Rabbit, though. I want to see that. That looks like a fun movie.
Here, this is the one.
Yeah, I've never seen that movie.
I mean, I don't know if I should recommend it, because it is technically a movie in which Hitler comes back to life. But it's good shit. You know, something the Dutch people and German people can really laugh at.
Yeah.
It also has a lot of social commentary to it.
No, which... I wouldn't be surprised about a movie like that. Like, I would not be surprised if they had social commentary about... Commentary.
Yeah, basically the social commentary is how humanity is kind of on a bad path right now, with them going, you know, racist against immigrants and all that, how, well, you know. Because if you think American people are complaining about the Mexicans, then my god, do you have no idea how it's like in Germany or the Netherlands, where you have, well, a lot of stuff going down in the Middle Eastern, where, you know, there is war and human rights are being violated. So many refugees are actually going to either Germany or the Netherlands, and a lot of people really hate it because, oh no, where are they gonna build the new refugee center? Afraid it's going to be right around the corner. Even though it's more going to be like industry areas where, you know, not a lot of people live. Like, people love to bitch out for the sake of bitching out.
I'm a winner. A bit worried about the fact that he's running a long time. But we have now finished all of Lake Placid. After the stream, I will be coming back to acquire the... to check up on codes.
Go.
So, starting in, well, for Lake Placid and Slappy Valley, in order to get to the next world, you need to defeat a boss. Boss for Lake Placid is up here. And it's wrestling.
Of course it is.
Welcome to the WW Gex Wrestling Invasion of the Body Slammers. Muscle flexing can be hazardous to one's health.
Look, do we have to watch it? It's obviously staged anyway. Pro wrestling is fake, don't fall for it.
Boss is defeated.
Hey, Spartacus. Where did you learn those moves? Ever been to a Turkish bathhouse?
Hey, that wasn't me, I swear. Besides, I'm about to try out some new holes on you, my precious pinned.
You know what this is?
What?
This is one of those cutscenes where... This is one of those... Your parents walk in cutscenes. You know, like, are you in it? What the fuck is that? are you watching? And then you go like, no, Dad, it's Gex. What the hell is a Gex? Oh, it's pretty simple. It's a gecko that fucks you. What? I cannot even imagine trying to explain Gex to my parents. They probably be fucking pissed if they saw me play this back in the day.
Yes, they. Yeah. No. Anyway, welcome to World 3, Slappy Valley.
By the way, I regret going to ask this, but did they already fuck?
No. Oh right. I mentioned this during last stream, but it was too late because she joined me at around the time that Marta raided me because I was having connection issues, which you were seeing.
Yeah.
The final cutscene is them in a hotel room. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. In fact, the game kind of glitched out a little bit, and we heard a little bit of that after I finished. I believe it was Mystery TV or something. I don't remember. Anyway, there's two areas in Slappy Valley, but for some reason, the first area has no TVs. Second area does. And for this time, for our boss, we have the Lizard of Oz. Yes, they have to turn the Lizard of Oz into a boss stage. Sound warning.
What?
Turn the thing on. Yeah, I have no idea why the hell the warper makes that sound. I have no fucking idea.
Right.
The last level of this world is Anime Channel. Now, each one of these has something I absolutely hate. Anime Channel has four...
Yes, I also hate anime.
No. This one actually does a lot of stupid shit. Basically, this one... here's the three ways to three remotes, and you have to go through them all if you want to get basically all of the fly coins. It's a lot more tedious than that. It is a lot more tedious as shit. I don't know what this statue is supposed to be, by the way. Yes, this is supposed to be in the shape of a G.
Right.
But you can't guess what's in this area just by looking at the Grecian architecture. Yes, they have. Yes, we have a mythology stage.
Ah, oh, cool. What? So, are we gonna get any God of War?
No. Ooh, careful. But we do become Hercules.
Ah. So, like. Hercules, that's the guy from Kingdom Hearts, right?
Oh, fuck off. Mythology Network. This has a crap ton of... this has crumbly platforms. And it also has a... You know, it's also basically one of the most easiest stages to fall in.
Oh, so it's like, So it's like Hexagon from Fall Guys.
I... In a way, yeah. A better way to compare it would be basically...
Two clunky platformer from the 90s.
No, a good way to explain the stage, how easy it is to fall. Final Rush and Final Chase from Sonic Adventure 2. That's how easy it is to fall in this stage. And that's the first.
Yeah, this is going to shock you, but I didn't finish Sonic Adventure 2.
Come on, yeah. Oh, goddamn, come on. Yeah, I believe this one is the first stage we have to go to. It's either this one or the next stage. There are three stages in here this time.
Right.
Don't ask me. I think they wanted to put one of the Lake Placid stages into Mission Control, but they didn't think of it. Honestly, I wish they kind of did. It would basically make the levels even. Shit, camera! God damn, fucking camera. There we go. This, Mars, and one up, so if we keep those, we are going to definitely need these for the mythology stage. Like, seriously, we're definitely gonna need them. Like, honestly, if I choose a stage I'm not looking forward to, it's mostly the mythology stage. Because I'd rather deal with the annoyances of anime and the remaining channel that we're going to be seeing when we get through this path, than basically having a stage that's easy to fall on. Also, over here is the secret stage, which we're going to do once we get the remote of for Slappy Valley.
Right.
Because fly points reset if you go into a stage, so it's better to do that and better to finish up the hub world than go into the thing. Cool. Let's see if I can take the card back. Nope. About to go through the thing. Oh well. Yeah, because if you see the order for this one, you basically have mythology, the third one, and an anime. So basically, yeah, we are ending near the, we're ending near the boss for this time, which that's a good thing. Huh. A beanstalk. Wonder what's here. Our last channel is Fairy Tales.
Dave.
What's wrong with this?
It's a tall level. All vertical climbing.
I don't know how you get to that one, so hold on.
Right, you probably need to use the, you probably need to climb the wall on the,
Yeah.
The thing, and then do the slide jump and the tongue to catch, the thing.
Yeah, that's what I need to do. I just couldn't remember.
Don't ask me, I'm not an expert on platformers.
Yeah, I figured.
I just got a Platinum Relic on Crash Bandicoot 1 Stormy Ascend level. Okay. It took me a couple of hours. Oh, it took me more than a couple of hours. Caddy's
done all three games platinumed.
Well, yeah, but I ain't fucking stupid.
There we go.
Well, not to his level anyway.
True.
And besides, with Kadigris, it's people that actually care about it. With me, it's just, you know, personal pride. Like, the game ain't screwing me, I'm screwing the game.
Oh. Oh. Okay, now I feel stupid. Oh well. But yes, all three of these stages have a central thing that I hate about them. God damn it. Why do we have to have this? Alright, so that should be Slappy Belly 100%. Oh, no. Oh, we are missing some fly coins. No, really. Did I get you? Got you. I get you.
Also, how many remotes are there?
We have 27. And I believe... So the foreign mythology, that's 31. The foreign fairy tales, that's 35. The foreign anime, that's 39. The one that we're going to be getting here in the hub world will make 28. The four from mythology will make 32. The four from fairy tales will make 36. The four from anime will make 40. The one from Funky Town will make 41. Give me a quick minute. The four from the first level of Funky Town will be 45. From the second will be 49. And I believe that Rez will give you one, so 50, I want to say.
Right. And is there like a reward for getting all the...
I'm not sure because I've actually never 100% of this game.
Ah, so are you planning to do 100%
yes.
Now or?
Edgy, we're on the third world, and I've already been 100%ing the stages already. Yeah, we're going to be 100%ing this game. I'm sorry if I sound like a dick. I'm very sorry. I did not mean to come off as condescending.
Oh, no, it's perfectly fine. I mean, God knows how many games I unnecessarily 100%ed. Sure. It's just a thing of instinct, you know? Like, you see a game, you want to play it, and you want to get your money's worth, so you play it a lot.
Like, I would say this, there are only two games I will never 100% ever again. Well, no, three games I will never 100%. Well, okay. There are three games I will never 100%. Two, never 100% again. One, I will never 100% period. The two I will never 100% again are Final Fantasy X and Kingdom Hearts Broke by Sleep. Because fuck doing that shit. Because fuck doing the super bosses for Final Fantasy X and fuck doing all that grinding for Final Fantasy for Birth by Sleep. And the one game I would just period never 100% is Super Mario Sunshine.
But that's only 120 power stars. Or shine sprites.
That's 240 blue coins, and they differ on the level you're on.
Bad.
Fuck no. If I LP that game. I'm not 100%ing this game. We are just doing the bare minimum, and that is it. If you want to complain, tough.
It can't be that bad. Come on, how bad can it possibly be?
Have you seen the Let's Play that Johnny did for Super Gaming Bros?
Yes. I mean, how else can I forget? Hey, Johnny. Did you know that? Hey, Johnny.
Yeah.
Hey, Johnny, did you know that if you enter Corona Mountain and leave, it will drain the water? Hey, Johnny. Johnny.
Get it.
Johnny.
But it's like, no, I'm never 100%ing Super Mario Sunshine. I'll 100% Galaxy 2 over Sunshine.
But you get jack shit for Galaxy 2.
You get jack, at least 100%ing Galaxy 2 is basically, hey, here's some fun challenges, not, jump from this chapter to this chapter for all these blue coins.
Look, man, you can say what you want, but the green stars, to me, are part of the journey of 100% in Galaxy 2. And because of that reason, I'll never fully 100% Galaxy 2.
Exactly.
I'll get 120 stars, yes, but I'll never try and go full Grandmaster Galaxy. I mean, hell, I 100% at Mario Odyssey. I got 999 stars.
I still need to do that. Mario Odyssey. I still need to do that. I need. I'm okay. Good. There's one, and there's the other one on the other. I think good. There's the remote for this world. And now we begin the stages.
Oh boy.
Like I said, this is the one world I'm not looking forward to because all these stages have one thing that's bad. And honestly, this one's the worst one.
Let's get it on!
So, for mythology, unsolved myth stories, we have break the arms off of 5 statues, collect 3 golden apples, and find the TV at the end of the rainbow.
Move over, Argonaut. Here come the Gekkonauts.
Hop onto these panels to become Herkigex. You can break stuff with your tail, and you can also push stuff, but only for a limited amount of time.
That actually looks pretty dope.
It is, but like I said, honestly, this is one of my least favorite worlds.
Yeah. I mean, I'd still hit him though.
Yeah, sure, but still. Like, you look at this, this doesn't look so bad so far, and it doesn't. You might think, you're just a coward. But we still haven't reached the annoying stuff yet.
I mean, it can't be that bad.
Okay, you want to say that? Okay.
Look, it's just an innocent platforming part.
You saw those platforms crumble, dude. Don't think it's so innocent?
Yes. It gives you a challenge.
Yeah, the only reason why I did that was basically because I had that cloud. The later ones, they're not gonna add clouds. Okay, so it's like, it gets super fucking tedious super fucking quickly, okay?
Right.
And basically, like I said, they start crumbling the minute your feet touches them. Like you see, it's like it. I don't like. That's why I don't like crumbling platforms. To me, that is just cheap.
Yeah, I mean, I do agree that when the platforms are crumbling, you do need to go there needs to be some sort of flow, which is why, you know, I'll welcome any something like Sonic, but in something like this, I can see why it becomes a problem.
That is one powerful piece of machinery.
There we go. Yeah, get rid of those guys by tail bouncing on them. Which makes zero sense. Like, seriously, it's fucking weird that these guys die by being tail bounced on.
Yeah.
And there's statue number two.
I mean, it is a peaceful platform, so you shouldn't, you know, really take the logic of the game in consideration, because
true.
What logic?
True. But still, this is one of my least favorite stages because of the fucking whole, oh, let's make it super easy to fall. I'm not a big fan of those stages. It's like, to me, that's just really cheap. That's just really cheap to me, doing, oh, let's make it easy for a player to die. It's like, I mean, I get it, oh, we're supposed to be challenged. I get that. But honestly, the fact that basically the other cities weren't platform focused as much as what these are, that's just annoying. Oh, by the way, here's another reason why I don't like the crumbling platforms.
Oh.
Yes. And the next group, spin.
I mean, it cannot be that bad if you, like, get a flow freeze, right?
Yeah, but still, it's still a pain in the goddamn ass.
Hey! Are you guys playing cards?
Oh shit! Too far.
You never lock me down!
There we go.
Get to the aqueduct and drain the lizard, if you get my drift.
Fortunately, this is a knife. My hands will be sweating a crap ton during this level because I don't like a lot of the jumps. And yeah, you can go ahead, oh, you're just cowardly. It's like, yeah, but it's again, I was on this. Yeah, it's like, I don't like.
No, I'm not gonna be that guy.
The reason why I feel this way is basically I get nervous on heights. I don't think it's vertigo, but it's like, and I don't really feel it.
It's a feeling you're going to, like, it's not a fear of heights, it's a fear of falling. And
yeah.
A fear of all your work being for nothing.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah, the remote is all the way back in that one little alcove, so we actually have to backtrack. That also kind of sucks.
Oh boy.
Luckily, like I said, the crumbling platforms aren't over pits. Your settlers are suspended by clouds. You don't go pits yet.
But it will happen.
Yep. And yeah, it's like, the fact that I had to ledge grab that, like, that's one reason why I don't like that those stages. That's flow breaking. But like, I could have made that stuff had I not basically gone, oh, oh, I got the thing. No, I would have made that and wouldn't have had to, yeah. Also, I'm just climbing this up again now because we need to go in there because I want to get that, tail. Luckily, getting all the paw coins will give me another health pit. Yeah. But that is the first mission for this dawn.
Hey. So let me guess, it's going to be a whole lot more of this bullshit.
But we only went through a little bit of the stage.
Speaking of bulging, did I just say that out loud?
Yeah, I'm afraid you did.
I'm a bad boy.
Now to go apple picking.
Lock and load, little lizard.
Ugh. Luckily, we only have to do three of them, but they're a lot further along the thing.
Yeah.
Luckily, we don't need the we don't need a perky dex for yeah, luckily we don't need a perky dex for Pat for opening that one way again. We just need him for basically getting rid of the way to the moving clouds, the moving platform. Also, oddly, the tail whip does not kill the shield, kill the little centurion. If you're hurt, if you're Gex, if you're hurt, you Gex.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of really weird. And that is the first apple. This was a death.
Are you guys playing cards? Wormer, dead. Niedermeyer, dead. Are we going for our killing gecko bag?
Also, I have no idea what the hell these birds are supposed to be. Like, they have human faces. It's fucking creepy. And here we are back.
Maybe it's a part of Greek mythology that I haven't read about yet.
Yeah, maybe they're supposed to be harpies. Those are part of
it. Maybe not, because you do have to realize that if you have a bunch of gods, well, then the world probably isn't going to be the same as we know it. Sure. Maybe there are human-headed birds in Greek mythology.
Never know.
You're like, don't ask me. I once majored in Greek mythology, but I dropped out because I had a better course. Not giving a fuck.
I'm a good. Get it? Are you guys playing?
Alright. After two.
What, you mean the computer has revolutionized home computing?
No, I meant the second apple we got. We got the second apple. Alright, checkpoint here. God, I do not remember where the third apple is. It's either... Okay.
Move before I step on you.
Here, let's take a water slide back. Maybe I'm like...
Welcome to the Sultan of Brunei's bathroom.
There we go. That took, yeah. Up. Yeah, so first, after the first pause, check across the floating platform. Yeah. The second statue, yeah, we already got that one. From the first check, backtrack to get an ice block. Go back to the first check one. Okay, that's fucking weird. Because the only ledge crossing the checkpoint is, like, there's no other ledge crossing the checkpoint. Give me a quick minute. I'm going to look at a video because I do not. I usually skip the stage. To be honest. So, hold on.
Wait, seriously?
Yeah.
Wow.
Motherfucker, you see how many stages I can open up? I have access to the boss level of this area.
Well, yeah, and I don't blame you. As a matter of fact, I know that there are many games out there where using a tutorial is pretty much damn well required.
For some reason, you choose the third mission first. I don't know why. Alright, cool. Alright, cool. Now we're at the portion I need. Well, that is for people who are just staring at me with pause screen. I have no idea where the fuck this second apple is. I mean, this third apple is.
You gotta give them something to enjoy in the meantime. Why don't you give
them, so you guys can listen to music and get some quotes.
Yeah, it sounds about right.
I mean, it's nothing, but hey, at least you guys aren't getting silence.
Yeah.
It's all Greek to me. Welcome to the Sultan of Brunei's bathroom.
Okay, so far it looks like I'm actually correct in that, so I'm at least gonna go back to where I was.
I need to get to the aqueduct and run the lizard if you get to my group.
Yeah, so I'm at least gonna go back to that second checkpoint. But at least I didn't miss an apple. That's good to know, because the second apple we got was the one, is the actual second apple good. He's got him having a super confusing shit on that.
I smell heroes, my friend!
Damn. Oh, by the way, something that's really dumb. If the ice cube hits a wall, it will break. So I don't push the ice cube straight to the wall. So okay. All right, I think I. All right, cool. Alright, so we need to go back to being Hercules again. And then what we'll do is we'll remove that one pillar.
Army?
Alright, so God, he got off that fucking ledge. Thank God, because I was annoyed. Like, seriously, that really would have annoyed me. Alright, so I need to line this up. Fucking A. Well, let's see if I can try to kick. God damn it. This is why I do not like this stage. This stage is one of the worst stages in the entire game because, oh gee, let's do.
Someone skipped breakfast.
Because, god damn it. Edgy, okay? God damn it. Oh. Fuck, fuck, fuck. I think Edgy left me. That's fine. Well, once we're done with this mission, we're gonna go ahead. We're gonna end the stream.
Okay. Not left, just muted. I figured that if, you know, it was gonna take some while, there's no point in talking to myself. I mean, I can try to, you know, amuse the audience, but I can barely amuse my own audience, so...
I was still there.
Well, yeah, but you were busy.
I still both talk.
Besides, I had to take a piss, so...
Okay, that's an... God damn it. That's understandable. God damn it. I have to go all the way back because you don't know how to freaking program decent platform challenges. No, we have to rely on freaking overused things because god damn it. Ugh. Fucking stage.
I smell heroes, my friend.
Fucking stage. Sucks.
The Playboy Mansion. Yes!
Yeah, this looks like one of those typical PS1 jank registered trademark kind of
kind of
case.
Yeah.
Like, don't get me wrong, the PS1 had some amazing games on there.
It did.
But most of the PS1 platformers, holy shit, was it obvious they were PS1 era platformers? Because they all had the same problems.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, did we shoot God in the face already?
No.
Aw.
Milton Burley's the name. Pumpkin's my game.
No, right now we're just trying to move a fucking pillar to a spot. For a freaking bonus. Right.
And the pillar, is it possible to accidentally push it off the...
That's what I'm scared of. I will admit, I'm fucking scared of that.
Right, so you never tried if it's possible, so you don't know if it's actually possible.
I honestly hate when games do that, like, oh, it says that's super fucking bullshit.
Yeah. I mean, some games at least have the modesty to, you know, return the item.
If that pillar falls, then I'm gonna be working to get that damn thing off screen.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm kind of reminded about something I did in my stream of Super Mario Galaxy.
Fuck! Drain the lizard if you get my drift. Fuck you, game programmers!
Oh.
Fuck you. I'm getting that off screen. I'm getting that one off fucking screen now. That was fucking bullshit.
Yeah, no arguments there.
Fuck you, whoever put that fucking coin right fucking there. Also, between now and the stream, I'm gonna see if there's a different ending for basically doing this, because honestly, fuck this stage.
Milton Burley is the name. Humpin's my game.
Why do I feel... Why does it feel like at any point I can see a bunch of text scrolling on the screen saying fuck this level, fuck this level, fuck this level?
Yeah, like that's kind of what you can hear.
Yeah.
Oh, God damn it. Oh, hey, cool. At least I can get this bonus coin.
That's the sweet stuff, darling.
How many lives do you have at the moment?
I have 45.
Oh.
Wormer, dead. So it's not bad, but still, it's like, I hate these types of stages. These stages are designed to eat lives.
Yeah. Would you accuse the game of suddenly becoming difficult to padding out game time?
For this stage, I honestly will, because it's just a bunch of bullcrap. But it's like, because like, this is the one stage that everyone hates. The rest
to be perfectly clear, it's not really the game's fault itself, because every platformer has that one.
Yeah.
Like, every platforming game has that one level that really just sucks.
Yeah, that in a remake, the developers need to fix.
Or just outright remove.
No, I wouldn't say outright remove this level, but basically fix this level. I'm sorry, this type of shit is not fun. Doing fucking... there's another checkpoint. There's thing for that. Alright.
Yuya Kirby's plans to fix Gex 2020. Page 1. You know that one level in Greek mythology? Yes. Fix that.
Yeah, fix a lot of the stuff. Fix the draw distance, dude.
I mean, I feel like the draw distance would be a given on a new platform, because it can actually, you know, render everything in a distance. Once again, I don't know if the N64 version has this problem.
Yeah, that's right. All right. All right, so look, if I die here, I don't need to... Okay, so I need to get... Okay, so I need to get you over to the bus. Okay. You get up and hurry up. Thank you, sir. I got him at a stabbing motion. That's cool.
I mean, right now, I'm looking for N64 copies of Gex 3, and they're quite cheap for what you can expect.
How does it compare to the PS1 version? There are all three apples.
Hold up,
Alright, so I'm assuming I'm gonna need to do more platforming. Oh, shit. Get it! Fucking A, camera, screw me over. Fix the camera, to their thing, too, but that's also a gimmick.
Yeah. Wait, for some reason I cannot find the... Oh wait, Gex 3, Deep Carver Gecko, PS1, disc only, 1223.
Ugh, are you kidding me?
I mean, it's still pretty cheap, so...
That's amazing. God damn it.
Wait, let me see if I can find an NTSC copy. Because in that case, you know, it might be something worth of collecting for you if you
I already have.
Oh, you already have Gex 3 on N64.
No, not N64. I don't have a working one.
Ah.
At least I don't have a way to play on it. That's what I should say.
Right.
I don't have a way to play on it because I don't have an HDMI and.
My tail doesn't like you.
But granted, for the bonus point, honestly, I probably might just look up all the cheat. No, also I forgot to do the bonus stage. God damn it, oh well. Oh well, we can do that next time. We can start with that next time.
Yeah.
I actually do want to do the secret stages. If there's a, oh hey, you don't have to get all the remotes type thing, if it's one of those, then we're fine. We just skip this stage and do one mission and skip the rest, because honestly, it sucks. Makes me not want to touch this thing. I want to do this, like, god damn it. Fucking A.
Wiped out!
Come on, Gex, grab the damn thing!
Show me the money, dude.
Okay, so version differences. This is just a small list, so I'm just gonna narrate them all.
Yeah, no problem.
The PS1 intro FMV was replaced with a few still photos of magazines covering showing Gex and X-Ra while Alfred narrates that Agent X-Ra was kidnapped. The PS1 ending FMV was replaced with a cutscene showing Alfred on the pitch congratulating you. If you collected all the remotes, the PS1... Should I continue that or is it technically a spoiler?
Go ahead.
If you collected all the remotes, the PS1 version would show pictures of the development team. On the N64, you just get an extra line by Alfred congratulating you on finding everything. The credit sequence is different between both versions. The sexual innuendos between Gex and Agent X were removed. They removed the best stuff from the game.
Edgy, okay. I honestly figured they were going to remove the innuendos. So I'm honestly not shocked that, they got rid of the innuendos.
Right. The levels in the Mythology Network channel have different layout in both versions. Also, the names are different. It's called Unsolved Myths stories in the PS1 version, and Ed2 Gecko in the N64 version. The level in the Fairy Tales TV channel have different names in both versions. It's called Red Riding Hood in the PS1 version and Beanstalker in the N64 version.
I like that name. I like Beanstalker. That's funny.
The New York type city bonus stage changed / removed a lot of the signs and smut.
The first
PS1 secret levels, Dial A for Arson and Brave Heartless, were replaced on the N64 version with new levels called Peklek Polta and Temple of Gloom.
God damn it, game!
Yeah. Fuck the title.
And there's death. Because fucking AA camera had to be surrounded by a frickin' thing. Luckily, we have a checkpoint right where we are. But I don't know if the apple is still isn't collected or not.
Yeah. The one thing I don't like about that site is how they don't, you know, say anything about the graphical differences.
And I can't tell, so I have to go and check with myself. God damn it! I want to see how the stage is different from the N64 version, though. I want to see the N64 version, so I'll look that up when the stream's over. I'm honestly hoping it looks a lot nicer, because fuck the stage. Basically, all we're going to get is basically, here's this picture of the thing. We're probably not gonna get all the remotes then. Mostly because I don't really care for pictures of the development team, you know? It's like, it doesn't mean I don't care about the team. It's just, the development team pointing pictures of themselves in a thing, especially as a 100% reward, that's kind of middle finger.
Let's be fair. It's still better. It's still better than Deus Ex Mankind Divided, because in that game, during the credit sequence, you get pictures of the development team. But you know what's the best thing about it? The credit sequence is unskippable.
That's usually most credit sequences anyway.
No, most of the games I play allow you to skip the credits. But with Mankind Divided, they basically force themselves onto you, like, look, we made the game, please praise us.
Oh, thank God, this is the way. Are you fucking kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? I need to freeze a fucking skeleton. You motherfuckers. No. We're done. Nope. Fuck this level. Next time we're going to be starting, we're going to do the bonus level. We're going to do the secret level, and then we're going to go to the Beanstalk level. Because fuck this stage. Fuck the stage. I would like to thank Edgy for joining me, by the way.
As always, thank you all for watching. Have yourself a great evening, night, day, whatever the hell it is. And I'll see you guys next... Wait. Am I going to be in extra?
That's up to you.
I mean, I might as well say I am, because I'm here all the fucking time.
Yeah, you are.
Right? I'm like a tumor. You can't get rid of me easy.
# fuck myths, and we're going to be raiding my friend Jill. So. So, I will see everyone on Tuesday for more of this. Like I said, I originally started wanting to do 100% this game, but because of this stage, we're not going to 100% this game anymore. Fuck this stage. That is all.
What is that last word you'll say?